2009 is rapidly coming to an end. It's been a year of big stories for the Susquehanna Valley, from job cuts to vicious storms, and even the arrest of the dumbest criminal in the state. This evening, we begin our look back at the year that was with a look at the first 3 months of the year.
Good evening and Happy New Year. I'm Janelle Stelson. A bummer of a bowl game for Penn State after USC bested the Lions by 2 touchdowns tonight.
The Pennsylvania Farm Show is up and running, and today is Livestock Day.
Bad news for more than 300 workers in Cumberland County. Williams-Sonoma is closing its Camp Hill call center as part of a company-wide consolidation.
It's going to be tough because it's going to be hard to find a replacement job if you really like that kind of work, because there isn't anything like that around.
NFL star Plaxico Burress is in a Lebanon County courtroom tonight.
It has happened again. More job cuts in the Susquehanna Valley. Harley Davidson is cutting more than 1,000 workers worldwide, and hundreds are in York County.
The economy can't support us, you know. People cannot afford bikes right now.
The company says layoffs at the York County operation involve 325 hourly workers and 100 non-production jobs.
The Penn State Hershey Medical Center is also facing tough times. Today, it announced a hiring freeze.
Pittsburgh Steelers are now Super Bowl champs.
Yeah, what a great game. Yeah. That catch at the end of the game.
My word.
Congress has taken an interest in what is now the largest food recall in history, the salmonella outbreak involving peanut butter.
Earlier this month, a resident put up a sign that says, "Dear crack dealer, you can sell crack on this block and the York police will not stop you."
Continuing coverage of a deadly fire in Lancaster. That fire killed a toddler, also sent 2 other people to the hospital.
Neighbors say they did all they could to try to rescue the little boy from the burning row home.
Everybody, family around here, ain't gonna see nobody. I mean, we're not gonna just sit there and try not to do anything.
Everyone was trying to get in, and we just couldn't.
A Lancaster County native is attacked by a crocodile in Guatemala, lives to tell about it.
I heard the sound of like whoosh, like out from under the water. These jaws come behind my head, boom, clamp down like on the ears like that. Pulls me underwater, and then in a second or two I figure out what's going on. I'm actually being eaten by an animal.
In the 5 months his guardian angels have been patrolling the streets of York, leader Mike Smith has often seen the criminals run when they show up.
The visual deterrent is definitely working.
The jury says Abraham Sanchez is guilty of murdering Lancaster County businessman Ray Diener.
Well, tonight on News 8, we are gearing up to celebrate WGAL's 60th anniversary.
A setback for the Lancaster County Hotel and Convention Center. It won't open on schedule.
Tonight, a Coatesville fire company is dealing with the heart-wrenching realization that one of its own is charged with arson. Robert Tracy Jr. is the former assistant fire chief of the West End Fire Company, where tonight members are displaying anger, frustration, and disappointment over the allegations.
Robert points a gun in your face while you are in a hotel bathroom. So what do you do?
Well, if you are a retired police officer with 35 years' experience, you chase him down.
About 10 other cops came running out, and we arrested probably the dumbest criminal in Pennsylvania.
Destruction left behind by strong storms. Tonight, stories of survival.
The whole side of the house just exploded in on us.
First hit, York County, where trees were uprooted on Arbor Lane. Hail coated decks. Then the storm moved east. A tornado hit northern Lancaster County. The wind tossed trailers, homes without their roofs. The storm then targeted Lebanon and Berks counties, dropping more hail and ripping off shingles. And that's just the first 3 months.